Send it in my former church. Voda so yeah. Oh name. Oh sa. Sa. Voda so. Oh name. Oh sa. Raise your hands. Titi Bramo. And something is about to change. Oh, would you lift up your hands? Oh, God, yes, before your best of all. Raise it so high, raise it. And Sano Nipa. Yeah, yeah. Akra. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey. Let's enter another realm. Let's go somewhere else. Ansana, ansana, ansano. Yeah, yeah. Akore ese se katabaha. Masumo, masumo. Unyamie. Unkwe na masumo. Una, ya basumo, kanamasi, una wupa, asurunya, azasi, tiririri, una wupo, munipa, ino, ansano nipa, baya, akra, wayabio, wayabio, wayabio.
All right, so it's another beautiful day here again on V1 TV, and my name is Noel Elom Agidi, and this is where we have the time to spend a very good time with God in the morning before you walk out of your house. The program is Morning Dew, where we teach you the word of God, pray with you, just to encourage you to overcome your problems. This morning, we have a great man of God in the house that will be helping us into the word of God this morning. But before we do that, as we always do, I want us to read our opening verse. We're taking it from Psalm 100. If you have your Bible with me, you can just turn your Bible to Psalm 100. I want us to read the whole chapter. It's just 5 verses. Get your Bibles and let's all read together. Let's go. So it says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is good. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth all to all generations. This morning, the Lord has blessed you with another day, and he can only take the grace of God for you to be alive. The Lord brought us into the year 2019, and he started from the first day of January till today. It is not because you are perfect or you are righteous. It is just because God has been merciful to you. It's just because grace has located you for you to be among the living. We started the year with a lot of people, our friends. Some are insane, some are dead, some are on sick bed, some are nowhere to be found. But you and I are alive today just because grace has located us. And so this morning, join us even as we give our praise to God for bringing us to the last month of the year. It is only by the mercies of God that you and I are alive. This program is brought to you by Criswell Logistics, here in Hodea, into event management, whatever event you have, church, revival, crusade, funeral, wedding, just call them on 024-444-2954, 024-444-2954, and they'll make your event a memorable one. I'll be going for a short musical break, and then when I come back, I'll introduce my guest, and we'll go straight into the word. Go nowhere.
Of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day at the cross. And the burdens of my heart, of my rolled away. It was there, it was there.
So you will come back from that short musical break, and then it's time for us to go into the word. And I'm so privileged to have a great man of God in the house this morning. And if you listen to City FM every morning, you will listen to one particular voice. And I'm so grateful to have this man in the house today, and he's in the person of Reverend Michael Kwame Nagbawonu, the president of Benel City Prayer Palace in Accra. And he is here in the house today to teach us about Christmas, what Christmas is all about. And then I'm sure that he will be giving some mysteries into Christmas that you've never had before, and it will challenge you, and then and just give you some insight about Christmas. Reverend, you're welcome.
Thank you very much.
It's such an honor to have you in the house.
It's good to see you too.
Sure.
I like to, for people to call me a man of a great God. We say a great man of God. It makes me a little nervous.
Wow, okay. I'm taking that correction. Well, Bishop, it's good to have you here.
Thank you.
Good to have us. We want to look, since we're on Christmas, we want to look into Christmas. What is Christmas? Some say Christmas is about making merry, cooking our best meal, sewing some new clothes, and then traveling. When we talk about Christmas, we as Christians, what are we looking at?
Right. Thank you for the opportunity, and I want to say Merry Christmas to all our friends that are listening this morning. And we've experienced a lot of things. I remember Christmas at my time as a young child. That is where we came God. Then he entered into man and came into his own creation. So in theology we call it incarnation, or incarnation. So he emptied himself of his power. So when he came, there were things that you could ask him, and he said, except my father, except my father. So it's not that he didn't know, but what could make him know is like a tin of a milk. You open the tin of a milk, and when you open it, you pour the substance out, and you are left with only the container. So Jesus came in that container. What was the real milk had been poured out. And so in Christmas, he comes as a human being into a person. Now, some people have had questions in how we celebrate Christmas, because Matthew gives a different account. Luke gives a different account. In Matthew, he looks at it from his father's lineage. Then he talks about how Moses and was born in his time, and they were killing children. So when you read about Matthew, you see them killing children and those kind of stories there. Then Luke also look at it from his mother's line. And he also looks at how Samuel was dedicated to God in the temple. And so he also says Jesus was born, and on the eighth day he went to the temple. But this kind of theological questions do not really it doesn't make Christmas Christmas. And so I don't want us to dwell on the theological back and forth of it, but let's just key ourselves this morning into looking at Matthew chapter 1. Let's look at the father's lineage. Matthew chapter 1 from verse 18 running to the last verse, and pick some few lessons from that and key it into Christmas. And so I would love you, if you could read it for me, I'll be very glad. Matthew 1 from 18 running to verse 25.
Right, so Matthew 1 18 says, now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. When his mother Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child. The power of the Holy Spirit. And Joseph, her promised husband, being a just and righteous man and not wanting to expose her publicly to shame, planned to send her away and divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, descendant of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. For the child who has been conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you shall name him Jesus. For he will save the people, for he will save his people from sins. All this happened in order to fulfill what the Lord has spoken through the prophet Isaiah. Verse 22.
Yeah, continue to the end. Yeah.
Right. Behold, the virgin shall be with child and give birth to a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means, or translated, God with us. Then Joseph awoke from his sleep and did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and he took Mary as his wife, but he kept her a virgin until she had given birth to a son. and then and he named him Jesus.
Wow, what a story. You see, this story at a Christmas morning like this, getting ready to know the relevance of Christmas, I think pulls out a story. And like I was sharing with you earlier, we have heard about the virgin birth, we have heard about Mary, and we have all kinds of prayers about Mary. Then we have heard about the Jesus himself, and we followed it for some time. But there is a little we've heard about his husband. When we start the verse, he said, and it was time, when he says Mary, he said, and the birth of Jesus was in this way. The mother Mary was going to marry to Joseph. Now, if you are writing a wedding card for a wedding invitation, you don't write the lady's name first before the man's name. But why did they mention Mary first and leave and now come to Joseph? He said Mary was engaged to go to marry to Joseph. So we realize that from the word go, Joseph had been given a silence name. But there are so many things you and I can pick from this lesson. And this morning, I want to pick some lessons from Joseph that we see in scripture, in the story we read. So Joseph now is going to marry this beautiful girl. He wakes up in the morning, he visits the girl, then he saw that the girl started vomiting, started behaving like he's pregnant. Then he watched her and said, this girl have not touched her. Because in the olden days, when we marry, the first night they will put a white cloth on your bed. And so when you have the first intimacy, they will come to check whether the girl was a virgin. Joseph realized that if I take this girl, I'm going to embarrass her. And he's a holy man, so I don't want to do it publicly. Let me go secretly. The next time she calls me, I'll not be around. She comes to my house, I'll not be around. So he had it in his mind, I'm going to leave this girl. Then whilst he was thinking about it, he fell asleep. Then in the deep sleep, God appears and said, go and take the girl, because what I'm about to do is divine. So in that lesson, the first lesson I want to pull out is that Joseph was engaged to marry to Mary. Now, in life, you want to get married. In our language, in area, in Volta region, you get up and you go and stay with the man without proper customary rights. It's not done. In this Christmas, if you have packed yourself on a man because he's buying credits for you, you've packed yourself on a man because he's helping you to buy lease, you have packed yourself on a man because he's helping you to take care of certain needs of your house. When you go outside, he said, we are living together. So he takes care of the light bill, you take care of the water bill, he takes care of your clothes. He said, my baby's father, my baby's mother. Now, Joseph was engaged, properly engaged. So we should learn today that our bridal price should be fully paid for. There are too many jumping girls, jumping women. We are hungry to marry. If you really want me to marry, let me test you small. And so let me press small, let me do something small. But Joseph, he showed us that we must pay our dowry fully. So if you are living with somebody this morning and you are getting to Christmas, the person has not paid your dowry, you are living there cooking a jengpele for the person, cooking a mobitani for the person, doing jollof for the person, I call you today that the one you are celebrating, he was, they fully paid the mother's bridal price before they gave birth to him. So don't jump on people when your bridal price is not paid. Number two lesson about Joseph was that immediately he wanted to marry the woman, he saw there was a problem. That means that every relationship comes with a problem. You see, people marry and they think that the marriage will stand forever. No problem will come. I won't have challenges because my husband is an angel. The problem that is happening is that you have married an angel and you are human. So angels and humans always have trouble. But if both of you were angels, we would have said good. So, but in this lesson, he found that immediately at the beginning of the marriage. Oh, then when I got married, I found out that my husband snores or his mouth stinks. First, I didn't know, because anytime I met him, he was chewing gum, picky. He was chewing something. So I never knew there was a problem there. So you realize that Every relationship starts on a problem. There are people, he says, because I fought with him, let's break up. No. Every relationship starts with a problem. So the next thing Joseph did, point number three, was that he gave us a method. Joseph gave us a method to solve the problem. Sometimes we have problems and we run away from the problem. But this Christmas, whatever the problem you have encountered, whatever situation has been pushed to you, learn the procedure of Joseph. And the procedure is that the problem must be solved. Have you ever seen a problem? Somebody took a cutlass and said, this problem, I cut it. Whether with a cutlass or I see people go to church with a cane,
yes,
and say, we are going to glass it. We are going to cut into two. No, we talk about it. Yeah. And you are going to go on there, assemble a cut. So sit down and let's discuss. Yeah. Talk about it. So Joseph is telling us that if we have a problem, we need to discuss the problem. Mm. Point number three Joseph does is that he listens to the angel because he fell asleep and an angel came and talked to him. Then the angel said, when you wake up, take the girl. So when he woke up, he listened. Why must we listen to angels? Angels are people or spirits God gave to us to control us on earth. They carry divine messages. Like Jacob was traveling, then he felt asleep on the way. Then whilst he was sleeping, he saw angels ascending and saw angels descending. Then that particular day, the angel said unto him that, where you are lying, I'll give it to you. I'll give it to your children. Then he woke up and said, wow, this is the gate of heaven. I didn't know it. So we must listen to angels because they give instructions. Two, we must listen to angels because they guide our life. Three, we must listen to angels because they deliver us from trouble. Anytime you see like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were in fire, the angel of the Lord or God himself appeared there. Now, when Daniel was in the lion's den, when the king came the following morning, he said, how did you survive? He said, God sent an angel to close the mouth of the lion. Can I pray for you this Christmas? That while God, the same way God was able to preserve Daniel in the lion's den, may the angel of God in this Christmas deliver you from any attack. Any lion that wants to eat you up, any lion that wants to destroy you, may the angel of Jehovah, just like he came through for Joseph and saved his home, may God come through for you and save your home. At this Christmas, this morning, I pray for you. You will make a mistake in life. That trouble will not swallow you. That trouble will not bring you disaster. God will send you an angel. Anytime angel comes, they solve a problem. Remember, the next point that we learned from Joseph was that Joseph took Mary for a census in the house. That is why I like this district level election, and I like the census and counting people going to the voters register. People feel that it is political. No, it is not political. It is biblical. There are times we need to do census. We need to see what is happening. But let me leave that because my wife doesn't like me when I talk about politics. So let me leave that one. But when he brought the wife home, this is the mystery, and it's a breaker to every man listening to me. When Mary came home with Joseph for the census, Joseph did not have a house. In his hometown, he didn't have a house. Because if he had a house and he had built a room, he would have gone straight with his wife to his room. But Bible said when they got there was no room. Because they didn't get a room till they even got only a sheep room. I'm telling you today in life, learn how to invest. People, we are using your money for beer,
pizza,
using for pizza, using it for calorie, buying pork meat, and enjoying with people with all kinds of things. Listen to me. Joseph took the wife home. There was no house for him. They didn't have a room. In this Christmas, learn how to buy blocks and build a house. Joseph is telling us that if you don't build a house, you will take your wife to a sheep room one day. This Christmas, learn how to build a house. Invest in a property Get a property for yourself. Get a room. Some people think that Jesus will come soon, so let's enjoy. Let's forget about it. Please, can I give you a message to Jesus? Tell him that I decided to wait a little. Me, Michael, I'm not coming now. So you can take the lead. I want to enjoy the earth small. At least the few things I've seen around. I don't have automated doors yet. I don't have automated cars. Where am I rushing to? I will take time a little. But one thing I'm leaving with you today is that don't live your life without having a room. Give yourself a target. Next year by this time, I would have built one room. Next year by this time, I would have built two bedrooms. Next year by this time, I would have built a three-story building. Next year by this, build a room. Men, stop eating all your money. Joseph is telling you, if you don't do that, you take your wife to a sheep room one day. And that is not the best for you. That you will go and put your wife at where sheep are. It's not the best for you. The next lesson we learn from Joseph, before I get too much trouble, is that Joseph was there when Mary delivered her firstborn. That was Jesus. He was there. He saw the baby. So men must be around when their wives are going through challenges.
Wow.
Men must be there to help. I've seen at first, there's a certain wedding I went to visit, and the married couples were nice. Their father knows that men, where men are, women don't go, and where women are, men don't go. Then when their children got married, he got to visit them and realized that both of them had entered the bathroom. Then he came back and said, oh, my child is wasted. My child is dead. They've cooked something for my child to eat. Why? Because he has never seen a wife and a husband bathing together. He has never experienced it before. And so he feels that it is wrong for a man and his wife to bath together. It is wrong for a man to carry a baby. It is wrong for a man to hold a woman's bag. It is wrong for you to do something with means for women. Joseph Lenz gives us a lesson here that when your children come, stay there. When your children come, don't run away. The next lesson we learn about Joseph is that he started the simple life with his children from the sheep pen. So we are learning a lesson today that you also, you must begin life at a simple level. Don't be in a rush. And the Akan proverb says a statement. They said, "Ufitichun sia moja neba." Okay, I explain. If you rush and you use brush to brush your teeth, the bristles will break your gum and you have blood coming. Don't be in a rush in life. Start life step by step. I know people are holding mobile phones that could buy a house. People are holding mobile phones that could rent a house. That could be a capital for your business. But because you want to become like somebody, you want to raise your life to a particular level. Joseph started with Jesus in a sheep pen. And so start your life at a low level. Start your life one step at a time. And as you grow, you will get into that level. Let me add two more lessons and pray for you this Christmas. I know for sure that this will be one of your best Christmas simply because you are following the lessons of Joseph. Next point is that Joseph was prepared to pay tax when they came home. The reason for the census was that they wanted to know so that they could tax them. They could give that, okay, we have this number of people from this region, and give the tax. As a child of God, look at Ghana. The way people are evading tax, taking things at bush road, using all kinds of illegal routes to bring things for Christmas. One day I went to buy a second-hand tie. And when I went to the tie place, they had inserted the ties, like 2, 3, 4, inside one tie.
Okay.
And they had imported them. So when they are scanning it to come out, it comes out as one tie. But inside the tie, there are 2 or 3 ties.
Wow.
Yeah, this is criminal. As long as you do this, Joseph went to go to be counted so that he could pay tax. Don't refuse to pay tax, businesswoman. Businessman, don't jump tax and use your money to buy knockout for Christmas and use your money to go and do hangings for your church. Don't waste that tax you must pay, evade tax and do some other things. Joseph is giving us a lesson. Don't evade tax. I give you 2 things before you switch off and go to work. And he says that, and Joseph strategically invested in posterity. He strategically invested in posterity. And I'll leave this with you and pray with you on these few lessons. I think I would like to end here and then pray for somebody on those two lessons right now. Number one, these are the lessons, and I hit it over it, that Joseph was married to a virgin. He was engaged and he paid the price. May somebody pay your price. Number two, there was a problem at the beginning of the relationship. Life always has problem in it. Learn how to solve it. The next point is that he listened to the angel and solved the problem. And the next one was that he lived in an area he didn't have a house. Learn to have a property. Learn to build a house. Then the next one was that he lived and saw his first child in a pen. So you too, learn how to help at home. Man, maybe gonna cut a towel, put it on your neck and you're walking, waiting for the fufu to be ready. Why would you take the stick and pound it yourself? Because you are the one going to eat it. Why would you spend time and still spend time with your family? You are the one going to enjoy. He spent time with his family. Then he started life simply. I live for you this Christmas. As I speak a word over somebody hearing me, I prophetically declare over your life, what your father couldn't build a house, your mother could not build a house. As for you, your children will not come and you throw them into a pen. May the Lord give you grace to be able to build a house. May the Lord give you grace to leave an inheritance for your children's children. I read my Bible the other day. He said, a house, houses are gifts, are inheritance from the fathers. I pray that you will give an inheritance to your children. One day you tell your children, I have a house at Ahoy, I have a house at Marketplace, I have a house at Sokobe, I have two houses at Takoradi, I have one at Kumasi, and you distribute it for them. Only, not only that, I died and I'm owing. I pray prophetically for you in this Christmas that God will open heavens over you. On this morning dew, may a dew of wisdom be your portion. How to use your small salary to make an impact. How to use your small salary and bless eternity. I pray for you at Christmas that this lesson of Joseph will deliver you from trouble. Shame will be far away. They will not throw your things outside. They will not carry the things you belong outside. Grace will be your portion in Jesus' mighty name. I love you. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Enjoy the best Christmas ever. And next year by this time, you will share with me that I solved my problem. I see myself living happily with a woman and my properties are gotten in Jesus' mighty name. Oh my God, I'm out of time. I'm not out of words.
Wow. Thank you so much, Pastor, for sharing this Christmas. I told you that he's going to share some mysteries with us this morning. And I knew you were all surprised, because I'm sure you were expecting something like, okay, and the angel appeared to Joseph, go and marry Mary, and then on the 25th of December, they gave them to Jesus. We know the story of Christmas.
That's right.
I'm sure you were all surprised about the lessons that came out from Joseph. And I want to believe that you take this into action. Be responsible. Get a wife. Pay the bride price. If you know you are keeping someone in the house, you know what I'm talking about. So do the right thing. Osamu, thank you so much. We're going for a short break, and then when we come back, we'll wrap up the show. Stay with us.
Thank you.
All right, so you welcome back from that short break, and then we are about to wrap up. It's not that we are out of work, but it's rather unfortunate that we have to leave. But also, before you leave us, maybe you have a message for us, our viewers, some Christmas message for them, or some prophetic word. Some are itching to hear something in their ears, so maybe you have anything to tell them before we wrap up.
Okay, before we wrap up, we're just sharing about a few lessons of Joseph, and something hit my spirit I want to speak to you is that Joseph listened to the angel's direction. Now, there are a few lessons about angels. Barak and Balak was going to curse, and an angel appeared. I pray for you in this Christmas, what is about to harm you, may the angel of God intercept it.
Amen.
In the case of Lot and his children, when they were running away from the fire, they got tired, but an angel came to hold their hands and help them to go far. In the midst of these years, you are tired because of what you went through January till now. You are stressed out. You want to give up. May the angel of the Lord hold your hand and take you through in the name of Jesus. Psalm 91 verse number 10 said, I will command my angels to carry you in their hands so that you don't knock your feet against a stone. This 25th Christmas, 2019 Christmas, may it be the best ever in your life.
Amen.
May the angel of the Lord protect you. Harm will be far away from you. Merry Christmas to you, your children, and your whole household. To all Christians listening to me, celebrate with caution. For those that are watching for the first time, I ask that the blessing that God gives will always be your portion. Stay blessed and always be on top. A friend of mine who introduced me to media said, don't do what the saint will not do.
Wow. Don't do what the saints will not do. Thank you so much, Pastor Michael, for coming
thank you
this
so
morning.
Much.
We look forward to having you again in the house.
Right.
God bless you.
Thank
all right, so viewers, two programs before we end the year. And the first one is our Carol's Night. I'll be calling for the video now so that you can watch and get the details of the video. And MCR, if you're ready, you can just give us the Carol's Night video for us to watch. Well, whilst we wait for the video, it's all about carols and it's all about Christmas. Now, on the 21st of December, at Hall of Strength Ministries here in Hall, the V1 TV crew and then Global FM are putting the Carol's Night together just to have a time with the, with Jesus, baby Jesus. We're going to celebrate Jesus, and wherever you are, we are inviting you to come, because you're going to see a lot of readings, you're going to see singing, dancing, choreography, and a lot will be happening that night. And don't be surprised to see Muta singing, see Randy, see Jijo, and all my colleagues here singing on that day. And it will be a great program. And the time is 5 p.m. Don't come late, because if you come late, you may not get a place to sit. And on the 22nd, which is a Sunday, we have Gratitude, organized by Strength Ministries here in Ho, and that one will take place at PIWC, Pentecost International Worship Center, right opposite Dora Memorial School Complex, Maui Estate, Ho. And then it's going to be a night of worship, thanksgiving to God for taking us from January till December. And if you are in Ho, the right place to be on Sunday is PIWC, for us to show gratitude for God keeping us till today. Make a time with me, same time tomorrow, and then your life will never be the same. This is where we end this episode. I'll see you tomorrow. Enjoy your day.
Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth? Matchless love and beauty, endless worth.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. On Saturday, 21st December 2019, V1 TV and Global FM, in collaboration with Hall of Strength Ministries, will be bringing you a festival of nine lessons and carols. It promises to be a night filled with loads of fun in the presence of the Lord, as your favorite V1 TV and Global FM presenters will be singing live. The venue is the Hall of Strength Ministries International of the Nurses Training College Road in Ho. The festival of nine lessons and carols will be live on V1 TV, Global FM, and also live on Facebook. The time is 5 p.m. Sponsors. Come, let's celebrate the birth of our Savior. See you there. V1 TV, our heritage, our wealth. V1 TV, Volta Region's premier television station, is giving our musicians a great opportunity to elevate their music career. It's a massive music video promotion on V1 TV. Call and book a slot now on 0205-521-290 or 0249-309-150. V1 TV, our heritage, our wealth.